Welcome to Amazing Aircraft, the channel where we explore the most amazing aircraft in the world. What is the most expensive and secretive bomber in the world? It is the Northrop Grumman B-2 Spirit, a stealth bomber that has been in service for over 30 years. The B-2 is a flying wing aircraft, meaning that it has no fuselage or tail. It has significant advantages over previous bombers due to its blend of low observable technologies with high aerodynamic efficiency and a large payload. The B-2 can carry conventional and nuclear weapons and can fly more than 19,000 kilometers with one mid-air refueling. The B-2 was developed under the Advanced Technology Bomber Program during the Cold War and was intended to penetrate deep into Soviet territory and deliver nuclear strikes. However, the program faced many challenges and controversies, such as technical difficulties, political changes, budget cuts, and espionage. The B-2 was first publicly displayed in 1988 and flew for the first time in 1989. The B-2 reached initial operational capability in 1997 and has since participated in several conflicts around the world. But how does it achieve such a high level of stealth and performance? Let's find out. The B-2 is designed to evade detection by multiple means, such as radar, infrared, visual, and acoustic sensors. To do this, it uses a combination of technologies and techniques that reduce its signatures and make it blend in with the background. Some of these are: the B-2 has a smooth and curved airframe that deflects radar waves away from the source instead of reflecting them. It also lacks vertical surfaces, such as tails or fins, that would create strong radar returns. The B-2 shape resembles an infinite flat plate, which is the ideal stealth shape according to the Huygens-Fresnel principle. The B-2 is made of composite materials that are stronger than steel and lighter than aluminum, and absorbs some of the radar energy. It also has a special coating that reduces its radar reflectivity and protects it from heat and moisture. The coating requires careful maintenance and storage in climate-controlled hangars. The B-2E's engines are buried deep inside the wing to conceal their fans and minimize their exhaust signature. The engines also have no afterburners, which would increase the heat and noise emissions. The exhaust air is mixed with cold air from the boundary layer below the wing and dispersed over a large area to cool it down and reduce its infrared visibility. The B-2 has sophisticated avionics systems that help it navigate, communicate, and target without emitting detectable signals. It has a low probability of intercept radar that can map out targets using synthetic aperture mode or terrain following mode. It also has a GPS-aided targeting system that can guide precision-guided munitions to their targets using satellite signals. It has a defensive management system that warns the crew of possible threats and suggests countermeasures. It also has a contrail sensor that alerts the crew when they should change altitude to avoid forming visible vapor trails in the sky. These are some of the ways that the B-2 achieves stealth, but stealth is not absolute or permanent. The B-2 stealth capabilities depend on various factors, such as weather conditions, enemy sensors, mission profile, and maintenance status. The B-2 is not invisible to radar, but rather very hard to detect and track. It can still be spotted by visual observation, infrared scanners, acoustic locators, or low-frequency radars at close ranges. Therefore, the B-2's crew must always be vigilant and use their skills and tactics to maximize their survivability. Okay, let us talk about how the B-2 uses a complex quadruplex computer-controlled fly-by-wire flight control system to stabilize and maneuver the aircraft, and the various avionics systems that are integrated into the B-2, such as the Low Probability of Intercept ANAPQ181 multi-mode radar, the GPS-aided targeting system, the defensive management system, and the common very low-frequency receiver. We will also mention some of the upgrades and modernizations that have been applied to the B-2's avionics over the years, such as new integrated processing units, fiber optic networks, software updates, and frequency changes. The B-2 is a flying wing aircraft, meaning that it has no fuselage or tail. This design gives it significant advantages in terms of stealth and aerodynamics, but also makes it inherently unstable and difficult to control. To overcome this challenge, the B-2 uses a complex quadruplex computer-controlled fly-by-wire flight control system that can automatically manipulate flight surfaces and settings without direct pilot inputs to maintain aircraft stability. The flight computer receives information on external conditions such as the aircraft's current airspeed and angle of attack via pitot static sensing plates, which are less visible to radar than traditional pitot tubes. The flight actuation system incorporates both hydraulic and electrical servo-actuated components, and it was designed with a high level of redundancy and fault diagnostic capabilities. The B-2 also has sophisticated avionics systems that help it navigate, communicate, and target without emitting detectable signals. The B-2 has a low probability of intercept radar that can map out targets using synthetic aperture mode or terrain following mode. The radar operates at a frequency that is difficult to detect by enemy sensors and can also change its frequency to avoid interference with other operators' equipment. The radar's arrays were entirely replaced in 2008 to make it an active electronically scanned array radar, which has improved performance and reliability. The B-2 has a GPS-aided targeting system that uses the aircraft's ANAPQ-181 radar to map out targets before the deployment of GPS-guided bombs, which can hit targets with high accuracy and low collateral damage. The B-2 can also carry other types of conventional and nuclear weapons, such as cruise missiles, bunker busters, cluster bombs, and mines. The B-2 has a defensive management system that warns the crew of possible threats and suggests countermeasures. The DMS can detect radar emissions from air defenses and alert the crew when they should change altitude or route to avoid detection or engagement. The DMS also has a contrail sensor that alerts the crew when they should change altitude to avoid forming visible vapor trails in the sky. The B-2 has a common very low frequency receiver that allows it to receive secure communications from satellites or ground stations using very low frequency signals that are hard to jam or intercept. The B-2 can also use Link 16 and a high-frequency satellite link to communicate with other friendly forces. These are some of the avionics systems that are integrated into the B-2. Over the years, these systems have been upgraded and modernized to keep up with the changing threats and technologies. Some of these upgrades include new integrated processing units that communicate with systems throughout the aircraft via a newly installed fiber optic network, a new version of the operational flight program software that was converted from an obsolete programming language to standard C, updates to the weapon control systems to enable strikes upon moving targets, and changes to the radar's operational frequency to avoid interference with other operators' equipment. Now, we will talk about how the B-2 can carry a large payload of conventional and nuclear weapons in two internal bomb bays. We will also describe the various types of weapons that the B-2 can employ, such as gravity bombs, precision-guided munitions, cruise missiles, and bunker busters. We will also mention some of the missions and targets that the B-2 has been involved in, such as Operation Allied Force, Operation Enduring Freedom, Operation Iraqi Freedom, and Operation Odyssey Dawn. The B-2 is designed to deliver nuclear weapons, but it can also perform conventional strike missions with a high degree of accuracy and flexibility. The B-2 can carry up to 18,000 kilograms of ordnance in two internal bomb bays that are equipped with either a rotary launcher or two bomb racks. The carriage of the weapons loadouts internally results in less radar visibility than external mounting of munitions. The B-2 can also change its weapons configuration in flight by using an onboard weapons management system. The B-2 can employ a variety of weapons depending on the mission requirements and target characteristics. The B-2 can drop unguided bombs such as the Mark 82 and Mark 84 bombs, which have a large blast radius and are suitable for area targets. The B-2 can also drop cluster bombs such as the CBU-87 combined effects munitions and the CBU-97 sensor-fused weapon, which can disperse submunitions over a wide area to attack multiple targets. The B-2 can also drop mines such as the Gator mines, which can create minefields to deny enemy access or movement. The B-2 can use GPS satellite-guided bombs such as the Joint Direct Attack Munition, which can hit targets with high accuracy and low collateral damage. The JDAM was first used in combat by the B-2 in Kosovo in 1999. The B-2 can also use laser-guided bombs such as the GBU-10 Paveway 2 and GBU-27 Paveway 3, which can hone in on a laser spot designated by the B-2 or another platform. The B-2 can also use electro-optical guided bombs such as the GBU-15 and a GM-130, which have a TV or infrared camera in their nose that allows the B-2 crew to steer them to the target. The B-2 can launch cruise missiles such as the AGM-86 air-launched cruise missile and a GM-1-9 advanced cruise missile, which have long range and low radar signature and can fly at low altitudes to avoid detection and intercept. interception. The ALCM and ACM can carry either conventional or nuclear warheads. The B-2 can also launch the AGM-158 joint air-to-surface standoff missile, which is a stealthy cruise missile that can strike targets from outside the range of enemy air defenses. The B-2 can penetrate hardened or underground targets by using bunker busters such as the GBU-28 Paveway 3 and GBU-37 Massive Ordnance Penetrator. The GBU-28 is a laser-guided bomb that has a 2,300 kilograms penetrating warhead that can punch through several meters of concrete or rock. The MOP is a GPS-guided bomb that has a 14,000 kilograms penetrating warhead that can penetrate up to 60 meters of reinforced concrete. These are some of the weapons that the B-2 can use to strike various targets with precision and stealth. Over the years, the B-2 has demonstrated its effectiveness in several combat operations around the world. In 1999, six B-2s flew non-stop from Missouri to Yugoslavia and back, dropping 500 JDAMs on Serbian targets during NATO's intervention in Kosovo. The B-2 accounted for 50 out of 34,000 NATO sorties but dropped 11% of all bombs. The B-2s also destroyed 33% of selected Serbian bombing targets in the first 8 weeks of the war. In 2001, B-2s flew from Diego Garcia and Missouri to Afghanistan, striking Taliban and Al-Qaeda targets in support of the U.S.-led invasion. The B-2s used JDAMs and conventional bombs to hit enemy caves, bunkers, airfields, and training camps. One of the longest missions was a 44-hour round trip from Missouri to Afghanistan and back. In 2003, B-2s flew from Diego Garcia and Missouri to Iraq, hitting Saddam Hussein's regime targets in support of the U.S.-led invasion. The B-2s used JDAMs, conventional bombs, and cruise missiles to attack command and control centers, air defenses, palaces, and weapons of mass destruction facilities. The B-2s conducted 49 sorties from Whiteman AFB and 22 sorties from Diego Garcia, releasing more than 680,000 kilograms of munitions. In 2011, three B-2s flew from Missouri to Libya and back, dropping 40 JDAMs on a Libyan airfield in support of the unmandated no-fly zone. The mission was the first time that B-2s overflew the African continent. The B-2s destroyed hardened aircraft shelters and disabled the airfield's ability to launch or recover aircraft. The B-2 is one of the most expensive aircraft ever built, with a total program cost of over $70 billion in 2021 dollars. It is also one of the most valuable assets in the U.S. military arsenal, as it can perform deep penetrating nuclear or conventional strike missions with stealth and precision. However, as the world changes and new threats emerge, the B-2 will have to adapt and evolve to maintain its edge and relevance. Some of the challenges and opportunities that the B-2 will face in the future. The B-2 was designed to penetrate the Soviet air defense network during the Cold War, but since then, potential adversaries such as China, Russia, Iran, and North Korea have developed or acquired more advanced anti-aircraft systems that can pose a serious threat to the B-2 stealth and survivability. These include long-range surface-to-air missiles, integrated air defense systems, low-frequency radars, passive radars, infrared sensors, laser weapons, cyber attacks, and electronic warfare capabilities. The B-2 will have to contend with these challenges by using its own EW systems, decoys, jamming devices, standoff weapons, and evasive maneuvers. The B-2 was built with cutting-edge technologies in the 1980s and 1990s, but since then, new technologies have emerged that can enhance or surpass its performance and capabilities. These include hypersonic weapons, artificial intelligence, quantum computing, additive manufacturing, nanotechnology, biotechnology, and directed energy weapons. The B-2 will have to leverage these technologies to improve its speed, range, accuracy, stealth, flexibility, reliability, and lethality. The B-2 was originally designed to deliver nuclear weapons in a strategic role, but it has also proven its versatility and effectiveness in conventional roles such as close air support, interdiction, suppression of enemy air defenses, maritime strike, counter-terrorism, and humanitarian assistance. The B-2 will have to continue to perform these missions as well as new ones that may arise in the future such as space control, cyber warfare, information operations, and special operations. To address these challenges and opportunities, the U.S. Air Force has initiated or planned several programs and initiatives that are aimed at enhancing and extending the B-2's capabilities and survivability. The B-21 Raider is a new stealth bomber that is being developed by Northrop Grumman as a successor to the B-2. The B-21 is expected to be smaller, cheaper, more stealthy, more reliable, more adaptable, and more networked than the B-2. It will also be able to carry a wider range of weapons, including hypersonic missiles. The B-21 is scheduled to enter service in the mid-2020s, with an initial order of 100 aircraft. The B-21 will complement, not replace, the B-2 fleet, which will continue to operate until at least 2050. The long-range standoff weapon is a new nuclear-capable cruise missile that is being developed by Raytheon as a replacement for the AGM-86A LCM. The LRSO will have a longer range, greater speed, lower radar signature, higher survivability, and better accuracy than the ALCM. It will also be compatible with both the B-2 and the B-21 bombers. The LRSO is expected to enter service in the late 2020s with a planned procurement of 1,000 missiles. The Next Generation Air Dominance System is a family of advanced air superiority platforms and technologies that are being developed by the U.S. Air Force to counter emerging threats from near-peer adversaries. The NGAD system will include manned and unmanned aircraft, sensors, weapons, and networks that will operate in a highly contested and denied environment. The NGAD system will also be able to integrate with the B-2 and the B-21 bombers to provide escort, protection, and support. The NGAD system is expected to enter service in the 2030s, with a possible prototype flight in the 2020s. The Advanced Extremely High Frequency Satellite Network is a constellation of secure, jam-resistant, and nuclear-hardened communication satellites that are being deployed by the U.S. Air Force to provide global coverage for strategic and tactical users. The AEHF satellite network will enable the B-2 and the B-21 bombers to communicate with each other and with other platforms and command centers in a highly secure and reliable manner. The AEHF satellite network will also provide the B-2 and the B-21 bombers with access to real-time intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance data and targeting information. The AEHF satellite network is expected to be fully operational by 2024, with 6 satellites in orbit. These are some of the plans and programs that are aimed at enhancing and extending the B-2's capabilities and survivability. The B-2 is a remarkable aircraft that has served the U.S. Air Force well for over 3 decades and will continue to do so for many more years to come. It is truly an amazing aircraft that deserves our respect and admiration. We have learned a lot about the B-2 Spirit, the most advanced stealth bomber in the world. The B-2 can deliver both conventional and nuclear weapons to any target on the globe while evading enemy radar and air defenses. The B-2 is a marvel of engineering, technology, and design, with a unique flying wing shape and a complex mix of materials and coatings that make it virtually invisible. The B-2 is also constantly evolving as it adapts to new threats and challenges from potential adversaries. Here are some interesting facts or trivia about the B-2. The B-2 has a nickname, the Flying Dorito. This is because of its triangular shape, which resembles the popular snack chip. The B-2 has a crew of only 2 pilots, who can take turns sleeping and eating during long missions. The B-2 has a toilet, a bed, and a microwave oven on board. The B-2 is very expensive to operate and maintain. Each flight hour costs about $135,000, and each aircraft requires about 119 hours of maintenance per flight hour. The B-2 has a cultural impact as well. It has appeared in several movies, TV shows, video games, and books, such as Independence Day, Transformers, Revenge of the Fallen, Call of Duty, Black Ops 2, and Tom Clancy's Red Storm Rising. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please comment, like, share, or subscribe to our channel. See you next time!